गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ लिपांजलि स्वाई, योर न्यू टीचर। टुडे आई एम स्टार्टेड योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर बुक। द चैप्टर नेम इज पार्ट्स ऑफ ए सेंटेंस। आई थिंक यू ऑल ऑफ नो व्हाट इज अ सेंटेंस। लेट मी क्लैरिफाई व्हाट इज अ सेंटेंस। ए ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स दैट मेक्स ए कंप्लीट सेंस इज कॉल्ड ए सेंटेंस। Through a sentence, we can express our ideas, our views, our thoughts from one person to another. This is called a sentence. There are so many parts in a sentence, like subject, predicate, object, a verb, an adjective, an adverb, etc. But the most important parts of a sentence is the subject. And the another part is the predicate. Let me give an example. Rama is reading the Ramayana. Take this example. Rama is reading the Ramayana. Here, Rama is the subject in the sentence, and the other part is the predicate. Is the helping verb in the sentence. And reading is the main verb in the sentence. How can you find the subject in the sentence? How can you find the subject in the sentence? Ask a question. Put WH or who. Then you will find the subject in the sentence. How? Let me tell you. Who is reading the Ramayana? The answer will come. Rama is reading the Ramayana. Here, the answer is Rama is reading the Ramayana. Rama is the subject of the sentence. Or the other part is the predicate of the sentence. What is the predicate? What is said about the subject, that is the predicate? Which things that tells about the subject is called the predicate. Let the example. Rama is reading the Ramayana. Who is reading the Ramayana? Here, Rama is reading the Ramayana. Rama is the subject in the sentence. And is reading the Ramayana. The rest part of the sentence is the predicate in the sentence. Students, listen carefully. When you find out the subject in the sentence, the rest part of the sentence is the predicate of the sentence. Let me give a trick to find out the predicate in the sentence. Predicate always consists of helping verb plus main verb plus object plus other words. Except subject, any other words which consist of a subject is called the predicate. When you find out the subject and put aside it, then the other part of the sentence is called predicate. If you have any queries in finding the subject or predicate in the sentence, please ask me. Then let me tell you parts of the subject. Here we know about parts of a sentence. Here we know about clearly parts of a sentence. There are two most important parts, subject and predicate. But now I will tell you parts of the subject. What is the main or important part of the subject? There are two parts of the subject. One is qualifier and the second one is head word. A qualifier plus a head word consist of a subject. Example, or what is a qualifier? What is the meaning of a qualifier? Who qualify the head word? Who qualify the head word is called a qualifier. Let me give an example. Some birds are flying. Some birds are flying. Here, some is the qualifier in the sentence. And birds is the subject in the sentence. How can you find the birds? Is the subject in the sentence? Put WHO who question, who WHO word or who question, and when you get the answer, bats is the subject in the sentence. Let me tell you another important point from this chapter. The head word of a subject is a noun. Always look that the head word of a sentence is a noun. Which is the head word in the sentence? That word is the subject. Look at this example again. Some birds are flying. Some is the qualifier in the sentence and birds is the subject in the sentence. Birds is the subject, at the same time birds is a noun. Is that clear? Then the most important, another important point is, and the head word of a predicate is a verb. And another important point, head word of a predicate. Predicate, the rest part of the sentence, are flying is the predicate. Predicates the head word, flying. The head word of the predicate is flying. Which is the verb in the sentence? Which is the verb in the sentence? Is that clear? For today's class, I just clarify what is the meaning of sentence, what is the most important part of the sentence, how can you find out the subject and the predicate, and what is the predicate consist of, and parts of the subject. If you have any doubts, any queries about this part of the chapter, then please ask me. The next part of the chapter I will teach you in the next class. Goodbye, students.